That's why it's love that we reppin' full. Put me in the game, I'm a effin' pool.
What's good, everyone? Welcome back to the channel.
We've been collecting seeds from our food in anticipation of the spring season to grow in our backyard.
In our first round of planting, we began in these recycled wooden drawers. First, we filled the bottom with some brown sea grape leaves from the tree in our yard. Then we added some organic soil. These paper cups were used to separate our seeds so they could sprout and be easily transported later on.
My mom also blessed us with this easy seed starting kit. So we planted peppers, tomatoes, cucumber, dill, and chamomile.
It's amazing how each seed produces one plant that then produces fruits or vegetables that produce more seeds to grow more plants, all engineered to fuel our vessels and feed the soil they came from. The more connected we are to our food, the more connected we can be with ourselves.
We were also gifted 8 beautiful papaya trees grown from seeds, so we planted them in our yard where they could get lots of sun. We added a few handfuls of our homemade food scrap compost into their holes and watered them really well.
This cool multi-section pallet came to us from the roadside, begging to be repurposed. So we grabbed it up and converted it into a tiered garden. We took weeding fabric and made 8 planting baskets. We cut large sections of the fabric and folded them in half so each section's base was extra sturdy. We lined the bottom of each basket with brown leaves and twigs from our yard. Next, we added some organic soil, then repotted our strawberries, basil, oregano, green onions, cantaloupe, watermelon, and honeydew.
You know we had to take some selfie videos to show some appreciation for our glistening, sun-kissed bodies. In this other, more regular style palette we found, we removed a couple of the wood boards to create 3 large rows. We covered the bottom a few times with some of our weeding fabric. You can use nails or screws, but we used a simple staple gun to secure the fabric to the wood. Just like in the drawers and the multi-level pallet, we lined the bottom of the bed with brown stuff. Sea grape leaves, small sticks, twigs, etc. This step truly is crucial and helps feed your garden beds for months to come.
We then added a mixture of compost and organic soil, then began repotting this beautiful rocket arugula, purslane, and wood sorrel that was foraged from our yard. In addition, a multitude of cantaloupe and various other melons, including cucumber, were planted. Dill, cilantro, calendula, and tomatoes, pear tomatoes, plum tomatoes, and tomatillos all went into that dirt.
We also planted seeds from a local mulberry tree, and you can see these 3 key lime sprouts are thriving.
Some days later, most of these little plants were loving their new home. We hear so much from media sources and politicians about world hunger and food scarcity. But as you can see, with moderate effort, we were able to create multiple transportable starter gardens packed with so much potential food. It's so much that we couldn't possibly eat it all ourselves, so we will definitely be sharing. Part of solving the so-called hunger issues throughout the world's population may just be as simple as planting your seeds and sharing what comes from them. Nature provides what we need, as long as we don't block our blessings.
You can also convert a recycled plastic container into a mini greenhouse. We have papaya seeds, sour orange seeds, and more key lime seeds in here.
Some people think it's difficult to grow your own food, but really it's not much more than adding seeds into the soil. Similar to us humans, the seeds have all the genetic information inside them to be all they need to be. What a beautiful parallel. Curating the proper environment to thrive and be fruitful is key to both gardening and to living life.
Stay tuned for more garden updates, and
thanks for watching.
So I mash the button, don't ask for nothing. I'm taking mine, I'm past discussions. No average, nothing around here. Making waves that'll drown fear.